Hey everyone, Christopher Gattelli here. I'm here with Playbill, and we are about to teach you a little section of Corn Puddin, one of our numbers from the series Schmigadoon.
She eats it constantly. Sometimes I get to wondering, does she love it more than me? Does she love it more than me?
I mean, starting from the very beginning, I mean, normally you work in a process where you're showing people like previs and you're showing them like you can like walk into a space and like into a studio and create something and have a director look at it or, you know, and give feedback. And in this time and that very specific time, you know, we couldn't come to New York and even rehearse in a studio here because they were all closed and mandates on everything. So we actually, one of the performers in our pre-production, Bethany Pettigrew, had a yoga studio that they allowed us to work in. So we had 8 dancers to work with in a studio because we had to keep socially distant, all of this stuff. Like, it was, you know, we all had masks. They had someone there as a representative, like testing us every day, doing rapid tests. We had to break every 10 minutes to sanitize because there's partnering. We had it was unlike anything ever. I mean, and I think at this point, you know, most of us maybe have been through it now, so it's not so new, but in the time, this was before vaccines. It was literally like right at the start of the pandemic, like when it was like things were gearing up to happen. So we started there and we were there for about 10 days and then flew to Vancouver, did my 14-day quarantine, and then met all of the brilliant performers there. But it was the exact same thing. I mean, you know, we had a core dance troupe of 22 dancers, you know, they're doing partnering and lifts and everything. And every time they would touch each other, we had to sanitize. You know, they were dancing in masks and shields, and you know, my favorite memory was, you know, like getting to know. I didn't know most of the dancers there because we shot in Vancouver. So one of my favorite memories was like getting to know them and working with them, and they were all so generous, and their spirit was amazing, and everybody was just so grateful to be working. And I think in that moment, you know, knowing that Broadway was shut down, like everything was just like down. And I think we all were so grateful to have that opportunity that like we were all kind of like, let's do this for everyone who is not able to do this right now. Like, let's celebrate that we actually get to do it and like, and spread joy and like, you know, let's like give this up to everyone who like is wanting to do this. So it was a really beautiful atmosphere. But the moment that was my favorite was walking on set for the first time and seeing them in costume and their full faces. Because I hadn't even seen their faces yet because they were always in masks. So like, and that's, you know, when you're performing, that's half of the thing, you know, how you're responding, how you're smiling, laughing, blah, blah. So the first day on set to see them in full costume and their full faces was like, I just remember that being such a special day because like I got to see my cast for the first time after working with them for weeks. So it was a really, really special moment and a really special time. Corn Puddin specifically, I mean, it's a hybrid. Cinco Paul, who wrote the show, his was clam bake, his was kind of like, but mine was actually June is busting out all over. Because a lot of like, Corn Puddin was kind of an amalgamation of all of those songs in the golden age that like, they couldn't really talk about sex or all of that kind of stuff, but it was all innuendo, it was all, so this was kind of like the composite of all of those numbers combined. So mine was June is busting out all over, especially like in the last like few moments of it, we went crazy. But there's some like Ona White in here, there's some Agnes, there's some Michael Kidd there. I mean, there's even like the shots from the side were from West Side. I mean, it was definitely like a lot of those like sexual tension, sexually charged numbers, but so innocent and a lot of innuendo. So it was so much fun to put together. This is so hard to answer without giving spoilers, but I will say that that Josh, I probably can say it. Well, yeah, they crossed the bridge, you know, so there's a season 2. But we do, you know, there was a hint of it at the end of season one by going into a bit of like Sunday in the Park, a little Day by Day kind of thing. So we definitely progressed into like the late 60s, early 70s. So there's a lot of, oh my gosh, I don't want to give any spoilers because but it definitely gets it's actually a little darker, it's a little richer, you know, where the first one had a definite innocence to it, you know, in the way that all of those musicals did because of the production code and everything else. Like, it was very innocent. And this one is a little darker, a little more sensual, a little more sexual. It's really, really fun. So we're gonna learn a bit of Corn Puddin' from Schmigadoon right now. I have Lindsay on my left and Sam on my right. Lindsay was part of the original pre-production of the show when we had to do it, and Sam was actually in the show. So it's best of both worlds here. So we're gonna break this down. We're gonna start with the men's section first. So we're gonna start with our right foot. We're gonna hold our vests and we're gonna start walking on our right foot, and we're gonna start right, left, right, left, catch, left, right, step on your left, then twist on your right. Yes?
Yeah.
Twist, and then step, and then we're gonna do some flashy turn or some something. Does she love it more than me? So one more time. So we'll do it with the lyrics just so that may help you. So we're gonna do, my girl loves corn pudding. She eats it constantly. Sometimes I get to wondering, does she love it more than me? Does she love it more than me? And you can do anything there to help you there. And then the women's version, after the men present themselves, the women lift their skirts. They have four counts to lift their skirts up. 5, 6, 7, 8, they walk on the right foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, they bring their arms down and they twist to the right. 5, 6, 7, 8, they take two steps to the men. 1, 2, they flash their skirts slightly. 3, turn, 4, then they walk away. 5, 6, 7, same thing, they do a little turn or a gesture towards the men. Oh, he'll have to marry me if he wants the recipe. So with the lyrics, we have 5, 6, 7, 8. My guy loves corn pudding. I've got the recipe. And if he wants my pudding, he'll have to marry me. Oh, he'll have to marry me. And on me, from here, we're doing some step slap. So it's step, slap, step, slap, step, slap, step, slap, step, slap, step, slap. So that's the vocabulary. And each person in the number, they find their partner, and you do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, jump on 5. And we're doing a little kiss, kiss, peck, peck to each other. Peck, peck, or kiss, 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 kiss. Yep, so let's just do that one more time. Just the coming into each other. So we're starting on our left. We're left and hitting our right. So we have 5, 6, 7, 8. Left, slap, 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 jump, boom. Great. Good so far? I think we're good. So now we're gonna take the chorus and face front. I'm gonna break this down very slowly because it's very fast. So we have, you put the corn, slap, 1, 2, 3. So you're gonna make the corn here, jump, corn, slap, then you're gonna do 1, 2, 3. Now you're gonna, so it's lyrically just so it matches up and we don't get ahead of ourselves. We have the corn in the pudding end. So that's the first section. Corn, slap, step, slap, slap. And one more time with the lyrics. You put the corn in the pudding end. From here, we do 1, 2, 3, slap. So it's gonna be a little, you're stirring the pot, stepping on your right foot. 1, 2, and on 2, you're gonna just do a little forced arch, a little chug there. 1, 2, 3, slap. Okay, So putting those two together, we have 6, 7, you put the corn in the pudding and the pudding in the bowl. You put the grape from here, put the corn, back to the corn, and we're gonna do a jump and click our heels and then land with our fist on our left hip and we're gonna hit our belly, boom, boom. You put the corn, you're gonna do a jump, you're gonna, hands are gonna be flexed, you're gonna click your heels together, flex, land, slap, slap on your belly. You're gonna put your right hand on your, I mean your left hand on your hip, and you're gonna do right, left, kick. And it's gonna be a big, like, boom, boom, kick. Not to cover your face, because we don't wanna lose your faces on camera. So it's gonna be right, left, boom. And it's just a little low kick, but you should feel it in your gut. So those lyrics are, you put the corn in your belly, cause it's good for the soul. Great. We'll do it very slow, and we'll do it for, with lyrics for all of us, because we need to, and for you. So we have 6, 7, you put the corn in the pudding and the pudding in the bowl. You put the corn in your belly, because it's good for the soul. Great. One more time. Then we're going to do a little flourish at the very end, because it changes something around. So one more time. 6, 7, you put the corn in the pudding and the pudding in the bowl. You put the corn in your belly because it's good for the soul. So now next, the little variation on the very end is corn in your belly because it's good. You're going to do a pirouette for your soul. And you're going to land with your left foot flex, and it's definitely like a pullback here. So how this works, so we'll do it twice. We'll show you, with including the variation, we'll do it once because we'll face each other for the first one and then the second time we do it front. So we'll show you how this works as I'll step off to the side and do it, but we'll watch them. So we're gonna start after these little slaps coming in. Bum, boom, ba, five, peck. Peck, you put the corn in the pudding and the pudding in the bowl. You put the corn in your belly because it's front, front, kick. Corn in the pudding and the pudding in the bowl. Corn in your belly because it's then land. Yes, and they stick it. Yes. Great. So now we're going to do it all together with the music at tempo, which is brisk and fun. Six, seven, eight.
My gal loves corn pudding. She eats it constantly. Sometimes I get to wondering, does she love it more than me? Does she love it more than me?
All right, so now we're gonna let Sam and Lindsay do it together so you can see the whole thing without me being involved and watch it nice and clean. Here we go.
Corn pudding, corn pudding, corn pudding, corn pudding, corn pudding, corn pudding.
We all thought of this.
6, 7, 8.
My gal loves corn pudding. She eats it constantly. Sometimes I get to wondering, does she love it more than me? Does she love it more than me?
Thanks for spending time with us today, and I also want to thank Lindsay and Sam for coming in and doing this fast choreography. And so thank you, Playbill, for giving us this time. We really appreciate it. Enjoy the show, Schmigadoon. It's on Apple TV Plus, and look forward to season 2 coming out very soon. We just wrapped a couple days ago. I think you're going to be really excited about it, and thanks for joining us.
But if you've got some extra.
extra.
I sure would like a taste.